My name is Marcia Levy, and I'm the Executive Director of Volunteers of Legal Service, also known as VOLS. Several months ago, before COVID-19, VOLS, along with other legal service organizations, participated in a community listening meeting in the Bronx, the purpose of which was to find out what the community leaders would say were the greatest issues facing their constituents. The first local leader to testify said that the greatest challenge to the community was the high rents for local businesses that were pushing them out, the impact on the community of losing mom-and-pop stores, and the impact on the individual owner. She declared, "We need help. Who can help these businesses?" I raised my hand. I described how VOLS Micro Enterprise Project helps small businesses with formative, contractual, and IP issues, and that our commercial lease assistance program helps keep businesses in place by negotiating with their landlords. If that meeting was held today remotely, I talk about co-founding with Strook the Small Business Legal Relief Alliance Program, and the 6 legal service organizations and 25 law firms and companies who together have represented 300 small businesses. Those of you at home, raise your hand if you or your firm, your company, has provided pro bono assistance to a small business owner. The next community leader to testify declared that his biggest concern was for the elderly population in his community, housing issues, legal status, health-related. How do we help? I raised my hand. I described how VOLS has an elder law project that works with senior centers and other community-based organizations to provide staff training and clinics to identify elders who need life planning documents and other assistance. Often these encounters are with veterans in our Veterans Initiative and their specific legal issues that they face. If it was today, I would describe how we work remotely with elders through our partnerships with these very same organizations. And I'd proudly talk about our Frontline and Healthcare Workers Initiative, while not limited to elderly, utilizes our expertise in life planning on behalf of the members of DC 37 with Lawyers for Good Government Foundation, Kirkland & Ellis, and 18 other law firms, giving peace of mind as well as legal help to those literally facing death by going to work. Raise your hand if you have helped an elder New Yorker or a frontline worker. So you know what I'm going to say next. The next person to testify talked about the immigration issues facing the community and who can help. And I sheepishly raised my hand. VOLS Immigration Project works with immigrant youth to assist them in a variety of ways to find a path to legal status. And now, of course, immigrants are at risk of poor health outcomes and in fear of getting medical help, and our many low-wage worker immigrant clients have lost their jobs and have been assisted by our Unemployed Workers Project as well. Raise your hand if your firm or company has conducted a DACA clinic and feels so excited right now about the Supreme Court decision on DACA, has handled a CIJ matter, or done an unemployment matter with VOLS. VOLS has been nimble in this crisis, doing the work we always do, figuring out how to do it remotely, creating new projects and even hotlines to serve the community. For those listening who don't know, you'll learn later that VOLS was formed in crisis, the cuts to legal services in 1984. Visionary leaders of the New York City Bar and 50 law firms and companies, many of you listening tonight, came up with a concept that seems so obvious. If pro bono volunteers could be partnered with legal service organizations, the impact on access to justice could be multiplied. That is the VOLS model. Think of us as an airplane. VOLS staff of 19 is the body of the plane, with 210 community organizations, one wing, 60 law firms and companies the other, enabling us to be nimble and responsive. Now more than ever as a legal community, we need to be raising our hands. In a COVID-19 world, we have seen the disparate impact of the pandemic on communities of color and the economically disadvantaged. The racial and social disparities are more in our conscious as we watch the murder of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and the protests and the treatment that followed. Opportunities come out of crisis, and this is a time for the legal community to be thought leaders and to act. In acting, I call on you to raise your hand, whether as a legal observer, a mass defense attorney, or bringing civil rights cases. And remember that the issues of inequality and disparate treatment are systemic for our legal service clients, whether those who are incarcerated and separated from their children, housing issues that impact low-income elderly, small business owners facing commercial lease negotiations when they're not even in their business, healthcare workers, immigrants, raise your hand to join with us now more than ever to provide representation to low-income New Yorkers.